Good morning. I thank you all for coming this morning. First of all, I'd like to just welcome the press to this event of the Conference of Black Senators, and I would like to introduce those who are behind me, and I know that some of my other colleagues are coming. I made some calls coming over, and people said, we're headed that way. But some of our mornings start extremely early here, and so I just appreciate you being with us today. We're here to announce and to support and pledge to press forward in the passage of a legislative agenda that we have produced. The Conference of Black Senators are calling for a statewide signature agenda of legislative issues. The mission of this conference is to ensure that we include in our legislative talks and debates the necessary measures to benefit the social, economic, and political welfare and the well-being of African Americans in the state of New York. It is our goal and intention to establish beneficial positions on critical issues of interest to African Americans and pledge our support to ensure that this signature agenda makes it to the floor this year. What I'd like to do is to introduce the members who standing directly to my right, First Vice President of the conference in the person of Senator Shirley Huntley. To my left is Secretary of the conference.
Treasurer.
I'm sorry, Treasurer. You were Secretary Treasurer, that's right. We have more officers now. The Treasurer for the conference in the person of Senator Parker, Kevin Parker, and in the back, a stalwart member and supporter of all of the activities of this conference in the person of Antoine Thompson. Each of the senators will introduce the bill that they have put on the agenda, and they will talk about, Senator Parker will talk about what that list of agenda items are, and then he will begin by explaining the bill that he is engendering to ensure that it get passed this year. And each of the conference members who are not here have a particular bill or are strongly supportive of some of the bills that are on this agenda. And I know the question that's going to be asked later on is why now? Why do we need a conference of black senators? And I'm hopefully that during the course of this presentation that question will be answered, and if you feel that it is not, I certainly have an answer for you at the end of this session. I will start with Senator Huntley.
Good morning. First, I would like to let you know my main issue is the mandatory control and school governance. This is an issue that affects lawmakers, teachers, parents, and all of our children. I hope that my colleagues keep in mind these children's academic goals and progress will be affected by this legislation that we create. Our ideas and efforts should be aimed at crafting an education model that will promote parental involvement and ensure success and growth for the children of the city of New York. As you know, the mayoral control sunsets June 30th. We're working very hard putting together legislation. Senator Parker has a good piece of legislation. We're crafting it all together, and at that point we will come up with a bill that will be good for the children of New York City. Keep in mind, 89% of the children in New York City school system, 89% are black and Latino. These are the concerns of this conference. Thank you.
Good morning. I'm State Senator Kevin Parker. I represent the 21st District in Brooklyn, which is Flatbush, East Flatbush, Midwood, Ditmas Park, Kensington, and Borough Park. And I'm the treasurer of the New York State Conference of Black Senators. I wanted to actually thank Senator Ruth Hassel-Thompson for her leadership and her vision in terms of making sure that this Conference of Black Senators meets regularly and does the work really sometimes behind the scenes that people are not aware of, but making sure that the voices and the concerns of African Americans, not just here in the legislature, but around the state, are being heard and being realized in the context of our agenda. We're being joined by a couple of other colleagues. Let me just take a moment to introduce them. We have Senator Stewart-Cousins, who has joined us. and also Senator from Brooklyn, my neighbor, Senator Eric Adams, has also joined us. Let me just kind of run down quickly the list of signature items that we're going to be talking about today. The first is Article 15A, which deals with women and minority business enterprises. The next is mayoral control, what I've been referred to in my bill as the Better Schools Act. We're going to be another item is mortgage foreclosures, the repeal of vacancy decontrol, which is a important bill being sponsored by Senator Andrea Stewart-Cousins, the Healthy Teens Act, which is being sponsored by Senator Vilmanette Montgomery, the Child Sexual Abuse Reform Act, which is being sponsored by Ruth Hassel-Thompson. The Property Relief Act is also going to be important, making sure that property relief is going to be is an important signature issue for us. Also, the New York State Fair Pay Act is another one of our agenda items. Reproductive rights. Again, Andrea Stewart-Cousins is the prime sponsor of that critical legislation that we want to see passed this year. Paid family leave and green collar jobs, which is going to be a bill that comes out of my committee, hopefully by the end of the year. We've kind of, and you all have the press release, but what you have here is essentially a cross section of issues from economic to education to health. To labor relations that are all important for the African-American community. When you look at these issues, I think some of you are going to probably be surprised that there aren't more issues on there that seem very, very specific to African-Americans. And let me just say, all of these issues are specific to African-Americans. African-Americans don't live in kind of a separate part of the state. They're part of everybody's community, and part of the everyday life of every part of this community, of every community in the state of New York. And so many of the concerns that we have as African-American legislators are not frankly different than Latino legislators or majority legislators across the state. And so we're here today to join our voices, to call on our majority leader, Malcolm Smith, to bring these bills to the floor. We want to see these bills pass this legislative session. We think that it's critical that these bills are brought to the floor, debated, and passed as soon as possible so that we can, in fact, address the needs of both our constituencies and African-Americans and just really New Yorkers across the state. In particular, for me, is the issue of green-collar jobs. And Senator Shirley Huntley already talked about mayoral control, and I just want to echo her comments. It's critical. We need to do it. I'm calling it enhanced mayoral control. I think that what you're going to see in all of our bills are things that increase transparency and accountability, that make sure that there is a real process for people, for parents to be participatory in their child's education, but then also to make sure that everything that is done as it relates to education is something that is part of a public discourse and not simply one man rule. So that's kind of where we are on mayoral control. Green collar jobs is critical because, as you know, we're in the greatest contraction of our economies, at least in 70 years, maybe when we're through this whole thing, it maybe ever. And so when we look at our next best opportunity to put New Yorkers to work, in particular, Black and Latino New Yorkers, green collar jobs is really that opportunity. Being on the Energy and Telecommunications Committee, I can tell you that is a growth industry that, in fact, is more than just a commodity. It's more than just something that we use when we want to turn on the lights or something like that, but it's also an actual significant industry. And as we move from carbon-based and as we break our addiction to foreign petroleum, it's going to be more important that we, in fact, develop our own indigenous energy resources here in the state. And as we develop that, that's going to be our opportunity to put New Yorkers back to work in everything from building windmills and installing water turbines in the Hudson to installing solar voltaic systems on people's roofs and building fuel cells. And those things can be done everywhere from Buffalo to Brookhaven to Brooklyn. And so this, the bill that I'm working on in my office, hopefully will in fact lay out an agenda that both provides training, but then also talks about how we roll out the project to both to do three things. One, put New Yorkers back to work. Two, lower people's energy costs. And three, clean up our environment. It is really by doing weatherization and retrofitting that we can have, you know, our best effect on both the economy and our ecology. And so with that being said, I wanted to bring to the mic my colleague from Buffalo, Senator Antoine Thompson.
Thank you. Let me say to Senator Ruth Hassel-Thompson, this is great, helping us put together a well-rounded agenda. As Senator Kevin Parker just talked about, it doesn't include every issue, but it's a guide, it's a framework for change and for progress. One of the things that I believe is critically important at this time in the history of our nation and of our in our state is to help minority and women businesses and gain greater access to public procurement. So reforms to Article 15A are extremely important as we look at not only the stimulus money, but also as we look at the opportunities with the state government. Yes, we are in a crisis, but the state is spending money fixing roads and bridges, fixing facilities, procuring services from outside contractors. And it is beyond time that we level the playing field and that we expand the bridge and road of opportunity for minority and women business in the state. And so of all these issues, I think they're very important, but I believe the ability to grow greater access for minority and women businesses in this state is of great importance, particularly at this point in 2009 when we see so much of a rush to not only put people to work, but to move projects along faster. So we must do better. I think Governor Patterson has talked about the fact that over the years, less than a couple percent of the procurement and business utilization has gone to MWBEs. We want to see that expand, and we want to see it happen now. Thank you.
Good morning. I just wanted to join my colleagues in really emphasizing how important these legislative items are to us, and certainly add my gratitude to Senator Ruth Hassel-Thompson for her leadership. I have certainly one of the most diverse communities represented in this council, but I think that despite the diversity, what you've heard over and over again is that we are looking at a big picture. We have a big vision, and we have a big vision that includes everyone. And that's why we're talking about things from paid family leave to keeping people in their homes when they're threatened with foreclosure, to increasing access to capital and state contracts with minority women-owned businesses, green jobs, because the environment matters, and people understanding the environment matters is crucial to us, reproductive health, so that women can, so that we can take the reproductive health out of penal codes and put it into a public health forum where it belongs. Paid family leave, so that should we be faced with a situation where we need to take care of a family member or a loved one, we are able to do that. I think that we are looking to bring vacancy decontrol to the floor, repealing vacancy decontrol to the floor and getting that passed. So obviously it is ambitious, but it is important. The agenda can only be underscored by the amount of vitality that we will be putting into making sure that these things that are critical to all New Yorkers and certainly to our Black and Latino residents are on the forefront of the Senate agenda. So I again want to thank you and looking forward to passing our legislation.
We'll now have Senator Eric Adams from Brooklyn.
Thank you, Senator Parker, and thank our chairwoman. Just briefly, we clearly should not view this as an insignificant posturing. We are in the majority for the first time in a long period of time, and at the core of our power are those that represent African American and Latino communities, particularly those African-American senators. And I believe what has been outlined here impact on many of the New Yorkers. And I think as a coalition, CBS is basically coming out and stating that we will use our power and influence as chairpersons and as leaders in the Senate Dems to make sure that we have a very fair, effective, and productive New York State government. Thank you.
Just a couple of comments in closing. One of the things that makes the whole foreclosure issue such a major factor in for this conference is that if you look at a map of where these foreclosures are taking place, you will see that they appear in the very communities that are represented here today. We don't believe that's accidental. We believe, particularly as we looked at the high loan levels that were being offered to people in 2005. And if you overlaid that map with the foreclosures that began to happen in 2007, you will see that it was a predictable behavior. Having talked with some of our congressional representatives and trying to ring the bell on this issue as early as 2005 met with no real success until this issue began to spread and have such a serious effect on our entire communities. One of the things that we are committed to doing is to ensure that we put together a series of legislative initiatives that will help us to work with those families that are targeted for losing their homes and trying to quickly put in place legislation that will disallow people from taking advantage of these as opportunities. And I know that in crisis there were opportunities, but I think that having wholesale communities lose their homes and families who have invested everything that they have through, in many instances, no fault of their own or through trickery, we think is outrageous. And so therefore, this continues to be a major issue. And we're very grateful for Senator Klein and some others who have been looking at this issue very seriously with our banking departments and making sure that we put money in this budget for attorneys and for authorized counselors to work with families to ensure not only those who are losing their homes, but as we go forward, to make sure that people who want to buy homes are better educated, if you will, about what the kinds of things they need to be aware of and how this investment can slip away from them very easily without the right precautions. The other thing, obviously, that has been of concern to me for 6 years since I've been here is attempting to get a omnibus bill on sexual assault of children. And over the years, I've watched many of my colleagues put together pieces of this bill, but still we have not dealt with the elimination of statutes that would make reporting still possible. One of the things I think that becomes a political concern here is when the church becomes involved and sees itself as the target.